Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Jansen Art Studio. Today, we're going to paint a lesser goldfinch. This is one that's found in the southern parts of America and out through the deserts a little bit. And we're also going to add a more southern tree called the jacaranda tree that they had in Southern California when I was growing up down there. And it's I want to do it because the lesser goldfinch is a yellow, of course, a yellow bird. We're going to do a female, so it doesn't have the real black and yellow colors of the male. Which is lesser goldfinch is different in color patterns than the American goldfinch, which I've painted in the Garden of Birds Volume 2. we did that one or Volume 1, one of them. It's a little bit different color pattern, and we're going to paint the female this time, which is not quite as yellow as the male, and doesn't have the real dark blacks as the male. Okay. But anyway, we'll get into that. Now, what I've done is I've kind of sketched her where I want her to be standing here on the like a branch, or she'll be leaning right up in here into the branch of the jacaranda. We'll probably put some flowers and stuff right up in through here. Sometimes I paint their feet, sometimes I don't. Birds' feet are like giant claws, or like I always say to you, and it just kind of like, it's like right out of Jurassic Park, and I find those sometimes not fitting with what I want to do, so I usually cover them up with something. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. But so I have her here, and we'll put some purples and some other colors around here, which should go very nice with what we have in the rest of the yellows and stuff like that. Nice compliments. I'll be using my Painted Simply colors. I'm going to expand the palette out just a little bit, but these are my six basic Painted Simply colors. I've added some pine green to that. For the painting of the jacaranda, I'm going to be adding some Diox purple and some quinacridone violet, two beautiful colors that work well together with that. I've also added burnt sienna and yellow oxide out in my colors. And these are globalized. All that information and stuff is for you, and all the lessons that we do here at the Jansen Art Studio. We have it absolutely everywhere. They're just globalized. This is about this whole palette and how I set it all up. So if all that information is for you, okay, let's get going. So I'm going to start out with, one of the things I like to do when I paint the birds is put them up against the sky. So I like to have, I don't always do it, but I like a real light blue. And since we're going to have a lot of blue violets in the painting, let's keep this blue just a little bit to the blue-green side, just to play that contrast a bit. Now, we'll gray it down just a tiny bit of the burnt sienna into it, maybe even just a tiny bit of black. That'll help gray that down, so we don't want to have it too bright here yet, but a nice light color that she'll play against here off of the back. And we'll just pull some of this right through this whole background. Let's step back just a bit more here so you can see a little bit more of the painting. And I'll add a little extender and stuff to it as I get next to her, so I don't cover up her lines a bit. I don't want to do that too much here. And we'll carry some of that color right down. Backgrounds are something that I paint the entire painting, so even though I may have quite a bit of it on here, I may end up restating and reworking some of these areas again, because I'm a firm believer in working the backgrounds like that. So, but I like to leave a few areas of just of the original gray color. This is an MDF panel that I've just based with some light gray, which is I use a lot of in a lot of my lessons. Light gray, which is just your white, a little yellow oxide, and a little bit of black. Or you can take some, if you have the premix colors, medium white and light gray in the Heritage line, and just add those with a bit of the sealer if you want, or you can just go directly onto the board like I do. And just base the board and lightly sand it and start to sketch your design. So I'll just back out just a bit here where she is going to be. And we'll leave some of that light color, lights going right around her. Sometimes when she is going like that way, I like to streak an angle through an opposing line through the painting, like this, so that if she's going one way, this is an opposing line, and she'll contrast up against the sky. And it's just something I like to do. I find little color movements like that to add more interest to the painting. Now, I want to take some of those lines. They kind of stop right here. And I want to drag those looks right on down and through. Now, down into here, we want to take some, you know, we're going to have some purples and stuff. But let's have some, and some greens. Let's have some nice light kind of greenish color, yellow greens and stuff coming up right down through here. That'll play really nice up against the purples that we'll have here. And this will allow us to pull some of her colors down and through. Let's just toss a little bit of that lightly back up in here and through and back. So there's some other little things going on. This can be distant trees, distant flowers of the jacaranda. They can just kind of go off there into the back, okay? So that just gives you a setup. Now that's just a setup. It's can all change. I'm gonna take some of that color and I'm just gonna push it up out of the way so I have some more room on my palette to do a little sketching. Now, since she is a yellowish bird, I'm going to do her a little bit like the Premier Coup kind of, where I come in and I do a little sketching of some darker tones. So let's just take some burnt sienna, maybe a bit of black into this with a touch of that yellow, just kind of cool that down. That black, just to tone that down just a bit. Let's come in a little bit closer here. Move over so that we can see her completely. And let's just do a little bit of the sketching and pushing in. I'm going to use my number 6 flat here, just some large area painting here. And let's add just a bit more black. And we'll look for some darker tones. A lot of times in some birds, I look for some medium tones right away, or what I call the undertone of the bird. And then sometimes I do this, which is more of a sketching of it. And I'll just kind of sketch right around. We'll go right around her eye there for a bit. We'll put in some sketches or some things that we know is going to happen. And we know there's going to be feathers here of her secondary feathers here. We know those are secondary flight feathers, and the mantle up here. We know some areas, a little bit of black with that here. We'll just sketch in, like her wing is going to come back here, and we're going to fold, just for interest, I'm going to fold one wing over her other one. Just a little bit of fold. I'll just slide the chisel right here to give a little movement. This area will go pretty dark. I've got to change this angle so this one here lines up a little better with that other wing there, with that. And then we'll go just a touch more yellow. Maybe a little bit of that yellow oxide with some of that black goes slightly greenish, which is one of her undertones. We'll just sketch that up right in here for the mantle. So when I'm working in her tones, I'm just slightly kind of adjusting it here for her areas. So I have black up here, burnt sienna here, and yellow oxide here. I want to pull the edge of a black at the other wing coming right up here on top of that. That might be a bit big, but we'll adjust that later. So that that one folds up on top of the other here. And that just will be another little set of interest and difference. Let's put a bit of a shadowy tone underneath here. This will be a brighter yellow, but we'll put the shadowy tone and burnt sienna and black. Here, let's sketch some right down through her tail here, which is going to be right down in here. We'll just streak some of that. That's a pretty big tail for her. Let's just let some of that fade away too, because we want to keep the interest up and around her face as we go to paint that. Now, instead of using the black, you could also use, we might put some of it into her, just to create a harmony, the Dioc's purple. Matter of fact, let's just add a touch of that out here. That helps darken the tone, but it's also going to be a tone that we use in the jacaranda, which will take that tone right into her, and you'll get a better harmony in your painting. So let's just use a little bit of that in some of our darker colors. It helps us cool that. Using just a chisel, we'll just kind of sketch, just a little bit of sketching here. We'll use this for her to start the idea, some burnt sienna and stuff here, to start the idea of her legs up here. And her legs are going to come back up that area there. We'll use a little bit of that burnt sienna right with this, and we'll drop that right into her her beak here. Now her beak is going to have a lot of coloring into it, so I'm just going to use the corner of the brush like that and toss that in. Let's take some more yellow oxide. Now she's going to be brighter, but we're just going to use the yellow oxide for right now, just right into here, and drop this brighter color of yellow oxide right in here. Boy, it's fun to paint these birds and watch them start to come to life. We'll use that yellow oxide almost like an undertone. As it gets backed into here, we'll gray that out. Even grab a little sky color, a little black, a little yellow. Just make a nice grade, lighter grade color here, like that. And we'll toss that down in here, and we'll actually walk that in, and there'll be the bottom of her. These are actually called tail coverts back here. They're covers, tail color covers back through there. Some of that gray tone can come into that. And we might put just a touch of that around up into her face. Up and around in her face here, I'm just going to use a lot of tones. I'm just going to tap with the corner of my brush here, little small touches of tone, and put a lot of those tones. She's going to get a lot of them into here. But I'm always going to be following here the contours of her eye and her face and everything. We'll take some of this nice mottled grayish tone here, and I'll strike a little bit of that right into her beak. Just don't take out all the burnt sienna, just leave some of those other beak colors in there. Okay, come in just a bit more. I think we can do that, figure that out. Okay, so now what I'll do is work the tones again. So now I'm going to come back. We'll take a little bit of, let's put our burnt sienna back up over here. And we'll leave this area for our yellow oxide. And this area in here is for our blacks and stuff. Okay. And what I want to do is come in and work just a little bit of a darker yellow. So take a little burnt sienna, tiny bit of black, some of that. And we'll work some shadowy tone underneath her. I'll come through with like a shadow tone like this, but I'm constantly brush mixing it. I'll come underneath her beak there. Okay. We'll add a bit here around her face, just a few touches of that into her face there like that. Okay. I'm also going to make the tone slightly greenish. So I'm going to take some, let's take some yellow oxide in this disc, slightly greenish. And this is a tone that she has a lot of on her. This is going to put it into the mantle, the back of her shoulders here, the mantle area, it's called. We'll push some back up here like that. And we'll push a few tones. That's a little dark here. We'll push a few little tones of that in here into her head, back like that. And look for little things like that, little bumpiness out there. It just works great. Let's add some of that tone back up under here as a shadow up underneath it for her main part of her body there. So we'll put some of that in there. Okay. Now at some point, sometimes I do it right away into a bird, and sometimes I don't. Sometimes I'll wait for just a second, like now. And I'm gonna go grab my, because she is just very wet here, I'm gonna grab my bridge so I can set my hand down and work in this area. I'm going to put a little burnt sienna. I'm going to use my smaller number 4 round. This is a number 4 watercolor round. I'm going to grab some burnt sienna here, and I'm just going to make some small taps of that color in for the round part of her eye there, just like that. Now I'm going to touch into maybe a little bit of that purple and that black here, and I'll come up to the front side here and just tap some of that. And not taking out, and you can actually make it a little bigger than what you want, because we can put the eye ring to take the size down. But I don't want to take all of that burnt sienna out. As a matter of fact, sometimes I'll even take some of that body light color lights like this and tap a little bit of that into the eye. All of that gives just nice, beautiful interest into the eye, where you get some of the different colors or tones into it. But the most important is that nice black that stays up there into the front there like that. Now And the eye is actually pretty big in shape. Let's take some burnt sienna while we have that here. We'll redefine some of the strokes here onto the beak here, maybe up into this area here. She has kind of like a little top ridge to that beak, and so it goes out and then back in. So we're going to paint this in and out of her face here. So we'll take some of this burnt sienna like this. She has a few other little tones, like a gray tone that goes down in there. You know, I like to just slowly add a few of these little tones around. Okay, now we'll take some white here. We'll come right down into this, model it down into this softer bit, and but you can also model with a little yellow because she has a lot of yellow on her head here. And we'll use just the very point of our brush, just the very point, and we'll come in here and we'll put in the lower eye ring here, the lower part of the eye ring, and maybe change the tone a little bit, maybe a bit more yellow onto it. Let's put the upper eye ring on right up there like that. Okay. Now sometimes I'll do both, is I'll take a little dark and I'll tap into that eye ring like that. Sometimes I take my shadow, which is one of the things I do is I'll make that shadowy kind of greenish color here, and I will paint out that eye ring to what I don't need to. It's just a tiny little eye ring there on that side, and then some of the yellow tone right up against that, just taking out some of that shadow. Let's take out some of that gray, the black and yellow here, a little darker, and take out some of the top part of the eye ring here, like that. But maybe a few areas of that tone coming up here into the top there to soften that. Okay. Now, sometimes I'll paint that eye ring a couple times back and forth, lighten that. And what you do when you're doing this is you're just adding more interest back and forth a bit. I'm a paint in and out kind of artist. I like to do these types of touches in and out several times to get the look that I want. I will also take a lower light, some of that grayish light right there, and let's just establish a little bit of a low shine, just a touch of it, and then a bit, tiny, tiny bit of the light for the light shine there onto the eye. And if you get that too big, I'll make that just a bit big there. If you get that too big, you can, a great color to tap it out with is some of that burnt sienna, because you know, we are using that into the eye there as well. So that's a great one. So let's grab some more of our black, some of our burnt sienna in that so it stays a little warm. Some of that burnt sienna and yellow there. Let's start tapping in some of the real dark colors here. Now, I pull in reverse. I kind of push the brush down like this. This is why I like this little number 4 for feathering. Kind of like that. And it's going to take us a few times here to get some feathers going that we want to have on her. Here, I don't want to go completely dark up here into the top part of her head, but we're going to go pretty dark there. Okay. We'll take some of that right down here in front of the eye and around this beak. We'll make some small touches around her face. Those of you who paint birds with me a lot, around their face is the smallest little feathers, little tiny. And so you just do little touches of it right around into here. And then we do bigger strokes as we get further out onto the face there. Okay, so let's get this a little bit lighter greenish kind of tone here. And we'll push some of that out with some of this greenish and change the tone. Maybe sometimes a little bit more, well, a little bit warmer. See, I'll change these tones several times and I'll come back into this area several times. Just quick little touches like that. Okay, I'll take some of that tone right up here like that and just touch through. And then I'll go through and paint some of the jacaranda and come back to this and paint again. I work around the painting. I work around. I want to leave just a little bit of edging here so it's not perfectly flat. So they see this, the edges of her feathers there. That'll give her some more interest. And so I'll work some lighter let's work some lighter, almost like a lighter, a little bit of burnt sienna into that. Almost like a flesh tone color, almost. Let's work a little bit lighter touches right here into her beak. Here. And those colors actually come down and into the face a little bit. Down like that. And I'll restate some of my dark, or a little dark stroke of that every once in a while. I go back and restate some the colors. This is where I get the interest. I paint in and out several times. So we'll go back with some of my burnt sienna. We'll come back and we'll add that bigger, lower, round part of the beak that's right down here. You usually see on the little birds like this, the round, little lower part of that beak there. Darker little color underneath it. Coming right up into the part of her beak. Just tap some of that around. So what's most important is that beak comes in into the face here quite a ways. It comes in quite a ways. A lot of people, when they paint the birds for the first time, is they tend not to take the beak into the face quite far enough. Now let's take some of that shadowy tone through. Some of that burnt sienna tone. I'll just tap that around here, right out into a few other areas here, letting that tone come out. There, like that. And you can lighten up. We can lighten up that beak one or two more times here. And just restate some of those little darks. Sometimes I'll touch it with my finger just to give it a little bit more of a loose look to it. Okay. Now, what we'll do is we'll come in and we'll start. I'm going to work on her head here for a few seconds and move over so I get a little bit of a area to put some Hansa yellow down. And I want to use my colors kind of thick. I'm going to put some Hansa yellow down right into this yellow oxide here, and we're going to use that to really start her yellow feathers right up in here. So we'll push that just short, kind of curving a little bit. These outside ones here, they'll kind of, if this is the center line of her face right through here, they'll kind of stroke out just a bit like this. Okay, and then we'll pull some of these up and around like this, right up through that other. Now, Hansa yellow is a very weak yellow, so this is going to take us a few times with this to build the yellows that we want. We could also drop in some white, but I want to keep this real kind of brightish yellow undertone there for right now. And we'll take some of our yellow oxide and just stroke a few of that back in here. Now, the other thing is, too, I like to use this small brush in and around the points of this, in and around the beak and the face and stuff like that. But as soon as I can, I like to get away from it because it puts in too much detail for me. There's a lot of artists that like to use small liner brushes and do little feathers and stuff like that with that way. I don't. I like a more painterly look to them, so I tend to go up to a slightly bigger brush. Now, you can go to like a, you know, even like a number two like this would work fairly nice, but I like to use like a 4, you know, and of course you size it to your brush. A 6 is what I was using earlier, but a 4 like this works really well. That'll allow me to put out some color here, put out my yellow oxide and some of these tones, and to do some bigger brush tone strokes like this. And I like that particular kind of look to that. So I'll be able to come in here like this and put in, and you'll see that softening of that tone right through that there. And we can build this color up. We'll take some of our yellow oxide tones right up here like that and down, and let that tone kind of come down there. Okay. And we'll let this, this is a little wet on her right now, so I'm going to let it tack up just a bit, because sometimes if it's if it's too wet, it's hard to apply the feathers. So I'll let it tack up. I'm going to put in a little more darker tone. Work that, state that one more time through here. Well, actually, we'll probably state it again as well. So I do it several times. So we'll do that up and around her eye here as well. And I took out part of her eye there, so I want to make sure. Well, it actually looks pretty good, so I'm not going to touch that yet. But we will put in some light. Some light's going to hit through there onto her. So, but we'll let that kind of tack up for a minute. Let's go down onto the wings. We'll take some of our burnt sienna and black here. And we'll go down onto our wings using the chisel of our brush. Now this four that I'm painting with is very old. It's well, you can see it doesn't even have a clear handle anymore. It is an old brush, and it might not be a real good one to do the chisel and stuff like that onto those feathers. So I may have to go back to my six here because I don't have another one with me right now. So that is really, really old. It has doesn't have a really too much chisel. I love to paint flowers with those, though. I never get rid of them because they make gorgeous flowers. So don't get rid of your brushes when they start to, frizz out a little bit, because they make gorgeous casual flowers. So I use my six here. It has a real nice chisel onto it there, like that. Okay, we could use a four for feathers and stuff down here. But when you want to be on a chisel like that, it doesn't work too well. And I'll push this darker tone back in here. Okay. Now, as a matter of fact, we can go back to it for some of these strokes here. Go back to our light here. Let's take our white and maybe a little bit of our sky color, a little bit of our gray here, a little bit of the yellow. We'll make a nice tan. Let's get a little bit of that burnt sienna in there. That burnt sienna we'll leave over here. Get a little bit of burnt sienna into that. So we get this kind of gray tan color here. Just a bit of white into that. Now at the end of these feathers here, they're going to be jagged like this here. We're just going to put a band of the white there. Okay. And for right now, I'll just grab my chisel, which... that one doesn't have that, so we'll take that one away. And we'll use this just like that, pulling up. We're also going to take some of this color and add it in a few other little areas back here. Back like in here. Okay. Just like that. Now, what we'll do is we'll take the darker color here. Black, a little burnt sienna, and a little bit even this Hansa. It makes kind of a blackish, brownish green kind of color. And we're going to do what we call negative paint. We're going to paint back like this, taking out and leaving just a little bit of the light there onto the feather, tip of the feather. So, and I will probably do this a couple of times, but see, that just leaves a little bit, and I'll go right down through the center there, and that just leaves a little bit of that up onto the tip. And it's a great way to make those feathers like that on these birds. The negative painting like that. Let's grab just a bit more black. Just so you can come back with a second tone, like a little black. Now, I don't want to make these too noticeable, because they'll be away from her face. And I don't want this to be about her flight feathers here. I want this to be about the... her face and the jacaranda blossoms. That's what I want this painting to be about. But so we'll do that just a bit, and then we can chisel and add the light chisel back in again. I go back and forth a couple times with these colors until I start to get some more additional, look to the wing here that I want. Let's add a little bit of dark right up in here. She has a set of mantle covers here, feathers right up in here. We'll push those in right up like that. We'll push a little light up onto their edges, just a bit of that light here. And I like to make it mottled like that which I have to go back and model that one. So I'll be doing that one again. But I like to make it a little bit mottled like that, so you get some touches of light and dark into it. Here. There we go. And then we'll take our dark, burnt sienna, and our black, a bit of that yellowish color tone into that, and we'll just come back a bit like this and set like little feathers right there, right on the edge there. Then we'll take some of our nice mantle-y colors here, green, yellow oxide, touch of black, just kind of stroke through here, get some movement to those feathers, and let's brighten up these just a bit more. So we'll just pull through here some brighter color, a little bit brighter yellow here. There you go. I like to use that brush like that, those quick strikes and strokes. I'll model down through that to get some other tones in, like that. Streak down through here like that. That's going well. And let's use a little more dark. I'll state all of this again. You know, it's, and this one of the things that makes your birds really pretty is just taking your time and coming in and adding the tones again, slightly different brush, slightly different tone. You get that modeling through of the tones, and that's what makes them so pretty. Now, and this time, we'll angle these feathers down this way because that's the way they go. So we'll pull down slightly like this. This is the top part of her mantle here, and then angle some of this down like that. We can even put a little bit of the light yellow and light here right against the edge of this part of her, and then use those darker tones right down to that, so she has a little, just a touch of light there on that. Now, we haven't added any of the light into her, but you can see some of this really starting to take shape on her. We'll put a little bit of the lighter yellow there, and a little bit of our soft light color back here, this part of her. We're going to let her feathers kind of go away there, but we will add some strikes, some heavier strikes of like some light that she might have right in here, right on part of our wing, and then we'll just use our chisel of our brush and paint some of that out there like that. So she will have some little touches of light that might show up here and there. I get all kinds of colors there. Now let's go back. We'll lighten up now, just like we modeled up on that one there. Let's go back and let's do this one again. And you see, it's again, I work it several times, restating it here, restating that light, and this time maybe model that a bit here and there with some of that light here, those lights that come there like that. Then we'll take those darks. Doesn't even have to, I really don't want it to be the same color, maybe slightly different tone. And we'll just paint out again, this time right down those feathery edges there, to push in those feathers there like that. See, and it just like that. This could have a bit more of a light coming up through there. There we go. That looks nice on her. Now she has a little bit of a darker black, which lifts the wing right off the body right here. Darker black edge stroke right up here. And we'll push that right along the edge of the wing here as well with the chisel of the bigger brush. Rather than a liner, I like the chisel of a bigger brush. It makes her more painterly. And we'll push some of that shadow right into that. Push some of our yellow oxide, a little bit of burnt sienna, right into that. Just tap into it every once in a while, and it'll take that color out and make it not quite so discernible. There's pop that in. That's good. Little bits of light tips to the wings here, which actually softens it against the background, which is a good part. Let's put a little bit of light right up against the edge there, here, and there, which is what she'll have on that folding over wing. And then we'll back paint some of that out, negative paint it out, down to a little tip there, like that, where that's crossing over. Other little light strikes from the other parts of the wings there. So I don't want to be too anatomically correct. I want to just be very painterly with it, but we just want to capture some of those looks on her wing, you know. Okay? So we'll let that kind of tack up for a second so we can work in there into those yellows and stuff a little bit more. So I'm going to let that tack for just a minute. And while we're doing that, we'll come back to the areas that we're going to be painting the jacaranda. And let's take some, we'll come right over here. Let's take some of our wonderful quinacridone violet and the diox purple here. And then we'll lighten that up over here. See those beautiful tones that are going to be here for that. Maybe even make it a little bit blue over here. That. Now, we can soften that with any of our greens, our lights, our grays, our yellows, specifically the yellows here. And I just want to model some of this light color like this. I'll put some extender into this. And I just want to come in, and these are what are going to be eventually be some of the flowers here of the jacaranda coming down like this and softly coming out. Maybe as we get to the outside here, we'll take just some of that blue and light and make it even more light and wispy down here so that they kind of fade away out here like this. Okay, you can even add a bit of that yellow-green out here that you touch into and just kind of softly push them out or touch them with a paper towel there. That works as well. We're just going to model up the tone. So here I'll add a little bit more of the quinacridone in some areas, a little bit more of the blue in others. We're going to push these flowers around here like this. Let some of them soften, get lighter out through here. Like this. That's going good. And now, we can't just avoid her, so we're going to take some of this right into her. Good reason to do this now. Some of this color will go right into her, back behind her, because there's other things in and around her. She's not just, you know, standing in to avoid it. They usually stand inside it just a bit. So we'll come right out here like that. That's pretty. Real soft. Real soft and light back up here. Maybe some just whisper, just using the corner of the brush here and just giving a light feeling of it right back here. Maybe a little purple into that. Just a real light feeling of it. Take that right by her face. There, right like that. And let's get a little bit more of that blue, real light blue violet here. This softens that in. Here, some of that right up through here. Right up to her. There. So a little, you know, just soft little feelings of it back and around her. So it's she's all around this whole, you know, all the flowers. They're big, blossomy flowers. Coming around it. And it's kind of pretty. We'll develop this just a bit more. A little bit blue, a little diox here. Let's develop some of our darks a bit more around. And this will give us contrast for our flowers that'll be coming here. So, and I want to be just very impressionistic with it. Very, very impressionistic here. I don't want to paint a whole bunch of perfect flowers of it. We'll paint just a few. Just a few. We'll let some of these layers of colors. So we go up to once and then twice, and we get this layering of this color through like this here and through just some different touches, and we'll get a wide variety of edges here going out like that. But we'll pick up some deeper tones right up in here, right around where we really want her to play up against these tones. So we'll get some nice deep tones, purples and a little bit more blue maybe, because they are a really purpley blue flower. So we'll get some of these blues into that as well. I love just to play the tones like this. Okay, now some of this I'm going to set to the back. We have to put the stems in of the flowering tree here as well. But we've got to soften some of this back out here, and we'll just start to pull this around like this and just soften it. Let's get our green back out here again. Our soft yellowy green here. Maybe a bit of white into that so it stays soft. And just pull some of that through. And you see that some of those grays that, I mean, pulling some of her tones down through here, which is great. Here. Because those two are complements and they'll gray each other a little bit, her head right into her tones. That's just good. We'll get some of this up. And some of this more is a green here, green tones. Some of it more of a darker green tone as well. Like there's the leaves and they have real leaves that have just a lot of movement, a little almost pine needle-y type here. So grab some of those. Here. Boom, out like that. Here. Very soft, very painterly here. And I hit her wing a little bit too much, but I want this whole area back in her to get very, very soft. Now I'll use the edge of my brush. Let's use some burnt sienna, a little black, maybe even a little of these purpley colors in through here. And we'll, that's a little dark. Let's go more burnt sienna. Maybe a bit of yellow in that as well. And we want to start some of the ideas of some of the stems and stuff here. And that's just a little dark. So I'm just making my paper towel and just wipe up like that. Just, I might just leave that, but it's just a little dark. We can put some green into that as well. Just to give some ideas of some stems and stuff moving through. And, I mean, we'll have all kinds of little stems and stuff out through here like this. And we'll pull through. And that's what she's going to be standing on. Some of these little stems that might be coming through all the way through this area. And just use the edges of my brush. And so I'm just going to mark up here some stems and stuff like that. We'll just push some of that nice soft purpley color back there behind her legs there, right like that. go. Alrighty. So that sets some of those colors in. That sets a lot of that modeling of those colors in. And we're going to now start, when we start to build the actual flowers of the jacaranda, there's, we'll use a large variety of tones and stuff. And we're only going to paint a few of them, actually. Rest of them we're going to let be quite impressionistic here. But we might want a little more blue and violet there. Here, just a little more blue and violet here. That. And just going to paint the idea of some of the flowers. Some of them will be a bit more. We'll just push some energy, some movement there, petals. Now they have, they're a tubular flower, but you usually, they're so tight, usually so tight that you don't see that, but you can give a few little longer movements out through some here, like this. Just strokes a longer movement because they are a tubular flower. Here. And this will take a few times to work these up the way I want to. So I usually come through like this and I start to add some movement. I will take some and like into the back here and make kind of a purpley. Let's get some diox into that. Nice lighter purple color and push some of those, like you see the edges of them here, like that. On the, against the lighter background, I'll put the darker color of the flower. And then as I come in, I might put a lighter flower inside here. So those two will play against each other like that. Sometimes hit a little more red-violet color or a little more of that quinacridone. Put a little bit of light blue into that as well. So you start to get some different colors there. Like that. She needs to get some light on her as well. Let's take some light. Just put an idea of some flowers back here into the back. Some movement here. Just ideas of that whisper. Movements. Around a few other areas here like that, just a whisper of the flower. Not the whole flower, just, you know, a few strokes of it and then just let it fade away. That's what's going to make them pretty. Just the idea of it. Now they have a little bit darker purplier center to them, which you can come back in and on some of these forward ones and just take a little bit of that diox, maybe a little quinacridone into it, and set a little darker center into some of them. Here, like that. We'll do more precise ones right in here and then just let it all, just like I did that right over on that side over there. We'll let this all kind of fade away and get some different movements here, just all fading away here. Takes quite a bit of these colors, but it's nice to constantly brush mix them up so you get all these variations. That's what we want to have, is these variations. That's what makes it all pretty. And I like little spot of that white hitting there. You know, that's what makes it really pretty. So you see I do a lot of brush mixing, a lot of just real quick jabbing of the color like this as I'm building it. Looking for, and I try not to repeat the tones too many times here as I change them around. Here. Let's get a bit more blue, lighter blue here. blue purpley color here. There, like that. A few more little touches here and there. And if you start to get too much paint and it becomes a little difficult, then you just go back to your bird, which we're going to go in just a minute. But you see, I'm just building these tones and these colors here, and that's what makes them pretty. So now I've got all these underlying tones. I have some purples, some red violets, some bluish color tones here, and a really, really purple, maybe a little more diox to some of these. So that tone changes, a little bit more diox here. It's almost like painting, you know, like hydrangeas and stuff like that. It's the same type of thing. The hydrangeas can have all kinds of colors to them here. But we need to get some nice light colors on her and her feathers and stuff to, before we can really tell how we're going to paint this jacaranda, how light we're going to make everything so that it stays softer than what she is. So let's go back up here, and then we'll come in a little closer again. Let's go back and let's work on her a little bit more here. Go back to like my six here, or my four that has absolutely no edge to it. Let's take some of our lighter yellow, our Hansa, and we'll add a bit of white to it this time. We'll make a nice light yellow here. Let's do some, we want to do a nice light stroke down. Maybe a little more Hansa here, stroking through here like that. And right back into our Hansa a bit more. Right into there, and out, and up and through there. Just streaking that stroke out. Just, we'll take some of that light right up here like that. Now, I do also a lot of negative painting where I'll take some of my greenish tone. We'll go right back up here towards our greenish tone. Hansa in black, or yellow oxide in black here. And I'll stroke back up through that, lifting back up through like that to create some more feathery type edges there. And I'll go back and forth. I'll wipe this and go back up and back and forth several times with some of those tones this way and create that mottly look there and a feathery look. And as I get up close, after I set some of the main movement, then I can come back and add with my number four round. But I'll use like the corner of this brush to add little touches of the lighter tone that comes through her mantle there. And then alternate that with some darker tones as well, because she has a lot of darker tones in that mantle. So you go back and set some of those back in again. And I'll go restate some of those lights in there again. Let's state that light whitish here for her neck, right down. Now, I'm probably going to go to my number four here. And we'll take some of our light color. And we'll come back right up underneath her chin here. Pull down. Well, this will shape some of these feathers. Here, pull down and shape some of these around. Little strokes. That's good. Let's take some of that light color right back here, right back by her eye. Just leave a little bit of that shadow. Pull some of that back in her, around her eye. We'll take some of that light color and stroke this way, which is her feathers kind of, her neck is turned here. She's turned slightly. So her feathers bunch up on this side here, And you'll see a little line of them here. And it just, and they kind of go at this angle here like this to the back. Here like that. And I'll do a lot of this too. Take out underneath. You can see the darker tone there and you can see the lighter tone. And I might add a little bit of yellow right into the center of that. Little Hansa right there into the center of that. As I play those tones and work those tones a bit more here. But when I come any time down towards that body, I like to use the bigger brush here. Like that, down. We'll add a bit more lighter body, bigger stroke, lighter body, softer, bigger stroke down through here, down through her body down there, through there. Okay, that's going good. But you can, I don't, you know, I like to do very painterly here. I don't like to come out here and do too many small touches. Now, she does have a very spotted mantle, her shoulder. But I, you know, I want to take the painter's license here of that and not do all of that because that's away from my center of interest where I want to paint her. I want to negative paint up here like this, though, and build up some more of her shoulder look here. Like that, so those feathers come in and out like that. And we'll pull some out back the other way. So I work back and forth like this. Take just a bit of the light with that. There, like that. Let's add a bit of that light right up underneath. And that'll help pop that beak off, which we still have a little more to do on that beak. A little more touch of color here. There. Restate those colors a bit. I hit them with some of that jacaranda, so I'll just come back and hit that again. Maybe another little stroke there. And then that lighter little area to the top part of the beak. That toned kind of grayed white. Sometimes I'll put a little bit more highlight there. Always watch that up against her eye. You don't want to make the beak any more prominent than her eye. The light part of the lower part of that beak, which is light. Tap some of that color around, which incorporates that beak into her face. A few little touches of this. Burnt sienna. Right around her eye there. That's going good. Little touches of the light right up through here. That's a bit light, so we'll go a little bit more yellow oxide. Right up on top of her head here. And follow the contours. So they'll angle out this way just a bit. Like that. And I'm going to take a little, little burnt sienna black and tap into that eye there just a bit more. And reset that eye ring, that real light yellow eye ring, just a touch more. There, like that. It gives you a nice little sparkle there, too. Sometimes you can tap right in there like that and get a little sparkle right to her eye. And take some of that light yellow and yellow here and just kind of tap through this area where her, the small little downy feathers, the small little tips of the feathers that you see right there, around the front of her face, between her beak and the eye there. We'll kind of emulate those in there. And I'll back paint some back out with some dark. If I get too many or too big, back paint some back out. Let's go back to our yellow, a bit of white, Hansa yellow, a bit of white. Add some nice light, a few little light touches that strokes through, and let those kind of set. Let's let those kind of come down like this and set this motion down her chest, her breast area. But that puts more light on her, which is what I'm looking for. There, like that. That's nice, and I don't want to go down too far. I do want to carry just a bit of these over the wing, which is one of the things I like to do on birds. That sets that wing into the... And we'll add a few little feathery strokes here. Right down there like that. Just a little bit of those. And suggest these, that curve in her neck, just a touch more. And you can do it a couple ways. Let me show you the other way I do too. I'll take my larger brush and go like this, which puts on a soft suggestion of that neck, like that, okay? And then I'll take that toned undertone color there and I'll paint up into it there to negative paint in some of that movement on the neck. And that always works really well. So we can use the reverse of that, like put that, you know, we have some light little edges here and feathers. So we can just show, and you know, she's all, oh boy, that's light. She's all mottled up really here. So, you know, you can use the bigger brush and tap through and add some smaller little feather lights and stuff like that through here. But you know, in all things, it's how much detail. And I like these to be kind of painterly. I like the interest to be right up in here around, you know, up and around her face and up and around her eye. You know, how much I go pulling down there can start to get a little bit of a trouble, you know, if you start getting too much. So it's best not to get too much. Now we want to preserve some of that shadow that's underneath her beak there through. So we just pull with that corner of that brush there like that. And I'm going to restate the top because I feel that her eyes lost here. Look, I don't want to outline it, but I want to restate the top eye ring there. Maybe a touch of dark right above that. Take that back down just a touch. I really like those. I really like to add those light little shines, though, to the... Let's get some white. Right, just a little tiny tip of white here. And add those little shines to the back of the eye ring and stuff like that, because I just think that just adds, when you come in real close, you can see, it just adds a lot more character to her, I think. And we can straighten that out a bit, just with a little dark. The more colors and stuff you do in there, the prettier she gets. So, we'll tap a wee bit of our light here. Let's take some of that out with the dark. There. And a little angled stroke of that up here. And again, a little dark. Now that's a little bit too severe there. Just a soft little look there. That's nice. So I like that in her, this yellowy area here. She's got this nice brighter yellow here. That works nice. I think overall her light works well. I'm going to use the point of my round, or just edge here, or the round here, and maybe put in a couple of the edges of her wing, just because that'll allow me, if I do some of this right here, that'll allow me to do a little bit more on the jacaranda up here, which I want to do. So we'll just give a light little edge there, because I want to do a little more to the jacaranda. We'll give just a little more shadow idea to her feet there. Let's take a bit of that nice light tan, maybe a bit of yellow, model these colors onto the brush, and let's add the lighter little stroke feathers that come out over her legs there. They will have coming down. Let's add a few little strokes out here. Give her a bad hair day here. Makes her look a little bit more wispy. Here, like this. A few little strokes there, like that. That looks pretty good. She sets up there pretty nice. And let's define her edge here just a touch more. Matter of fact, we could probably use even head towards the dark side for that edge right up here. Just like that. Just a little bit of that in there. And then that will allow that little contrast against the light and bring that front area there up a little bit more. We may need to have just a bit more light coming up here into the front. And we might have to let that tack up a bit to get more light on there. Sometimes you get this and you're going to try to get that light in there. It's difficult because it gets to be so much paint. It's easy to negative paint, but it's not easy to do them to set more lights in there, because you got a little too much color to work with. So we'll tap a little bit of the dark this way. Just get little touches of those tones, and they just do so much to her. Okay, so we won't really put, maybe we'll give just a touch of the light there onto her legs there. We'll set that into here. Now let's go back and let's paint some more on this jacaranda here. And we'll set some light. Now we can set some lighter colors. We can get little light edges if we want to, you know, really spark, and we can grab some of our yellows and put them down in there as well, but we want to spark up the edges of some of these. We can put some light and negative paint out to those edges, which carries some of her look as well. You start to look at how am I going to incorporate the look of the flowers into her, and so I'm start to think about tying technique-wise. I start to think technique-wise, how am I tying this whole thing together here as well. So the technique I'm going to use for the final bits of this, you know, maybe giving those edging looks to these little flowers like that, taking some light here, just edging your brush up with some light, and maybe using that to help paint the edges of these little blossoms here, this little jacaranda, and that will give you the same type of look that she has. You don't need to do it to them all. Just, you know, just a few of them here and there. Don't need them all. But we want to turn them all kinds of ways and do all kinds of sizes and turns. And maybe you have some where you see just the angles of the petals. You know, just so they're not all the same. Let's grab some more of our colors down through here. Get our purples, our blues, our quinacridone, our violet here. Get some of those nice purpley colors into those centers. Just tap those out like that. And let's get some of these. This out, few those colors further out there. But it's just some really nice that you play the yellow here against that the purples and stuff. They get those nice complements down, and you can take a little bit of that purple color and a little bit lighter than that. It has to be as light as it is on her body, and you can add a bit of that into her, just almost like a little reflection. And what that does is that ties the two of them together. See, so just a little bit here and there, maybe. You know, you pick up just a bit of it, a whisper here and there. So some of her there, and that just picks up that, and then her yellows come out just boom, out like that. We'll build. And build and build more light. I'm just watching these lights right up against her. How much I can do. So I put the light on. You got to remember the centers of these are dark. So we put the light on and then paint out a bit the centers. Paint out the centers a little darker. Just push that dark out from the center out into the petals a bit. But we get some darker blues and purples in between here as well to create some form shadow, some shadow from all of the flowers coming together, so we don't just have light there. So you have some of the form. Shadow coming in here. Here like that. In. There, just build those up a bit more and we'll start letting this all kind of fade away. I'm going to go to a little bit light, a larger brush here. Back to a little bit larger brush and just create some movement to these flowers out here, letting some of them just kind of go away here. Okay, and it's nice to kind of see some of this out here so you can see, okay, now I got flowers and then I'm heading away from those. Getting these flowers away. There, like that. There. Get those, you know, you can have a few little ideas of the tubes of those. You know, longer, straighter strokes for the tubes of them. Nice variation to the colors. There. little edges of petals maybe you see out here. Little edges, little sparks. Always call these, like I use the corner of the brush like that and touch this little sparks of color, edges here and there. Don't want to do a whole bunch of found edges, but just little ones like this, just kind of bring it as a whole unit of flowers. And they really, really paint nice with a slightly bigger brush, not a small brush, slightly bigger brush. That's coming well. We'll continue these looks out in here just a bit. Just a, you know, a few other little touches of the colors here, little light colors here, just a little further out. Here, just so you pick up some of those out in other areas. Nice. Put a nice light little petal right there. That'll play right up against her. Nice little interest right there. Boom. Right up against her there. And that'll play right against that little darker one there. And that right there, that little purpley color just helps that her pop off that area a bit. That's kind of fun. And we'll build just a little more shape, I think, into them. Then let the, and these outside ones here, a little more contrast here and there. We'll tap in some darker centers. A little bit of blue and some quinacridone, or you can use the diox here. Tap in some of those little centers. I'm going to make, this is really soft back here. I want to make it kind of heading away. So I'm going to put just a little more color here, right here. And then they're going to be heading away and then fading away as they, the color will fade away as it gets back there. So just a little bit more color right in here. There, like that. Those nice little edges that I gave there on that wing kind of disappeared because I hit it with all those. Wanted those to kind of fold over on top of that one. There, like that. That works. So they see that fading away, and let's do just a little bit of that fading away here. That gets more than just, it's prettier than having it just, you know, all faded. So you see it kind of going away. We can make those edges just kind of disappearing there, going back away. Yeah, it's kind of nice. Now let's get little touches of some yellowy green in there. And they don't really have too much of the leaves or something between it, but they can have like little green spots of stuff going around in there. So we'll just tap a few greenish spots to kind of break up some of the purpley color. Lots of yellow, pine green, and white here, just a few taps of that color through there. A few like little leaves here. But usually when the tree, what I remember from it, of course it's been many, many years since I've been around these trees, but they, when they flower, you don't see any of the green. They're just, they're really full of flowering up. We'll go down some greens down in through here. Even go into a little bit of the blue-green as it goes down here too, because, you know, you got the purples and stuff, and it'll go into that blue-green really nice here. And that could be a nice contrasty kind of color right down here. We don't want to get too much contrast, but let's get some of that cooler blue-green right down through here. Go, we had that kind of yellowy tone down through, but this will help. This will help as well. Some of those blue greens. Just get a variety of greens here. Yellow greens here, some blue greens. Here, tap some of these greens through. Break up that. Play the colors. Down like that. That makes it pretty. She sits very painterly in there. Just add a few more little stem movements here. Right there, like that. Some ideas of some stems and stuff moving through. Finish that up. And I think we're going to call it on her, because she's got just a real nice little look to it. So just a few ideas of the corners of these little stems. You know, soften those into the flowers there. And she looks pretty good. You might watch her, because she has a lot of dark underneath. You might watch her as she dries. Some of those dark colors might come back up through, and you might have to lighten her up just a little bit more. But I usually do that. I just usually just watch her just a bit. And also watch your flowers, too, because they have a lot of darks into there. You might want to come back as they're starting to dry and just hit a few more little light flowers, a few more little light blossoms here and there to pump those up as well. And that's an easy thing to do. Just watch it as it starts to dry, or go put it under the hairdryer for a few minutes and tack it up, and then you'll see just about how it's drying down. And then if you need to add a few more little things to it, you can. Okay, thanks very much for joining me. I had a great time painting her with you. Look for more of our DVDs, more educational stuff over on jansenartstore.com. You can always write to the studio if you have any kinds of questions. You know, and there's even a contact form over there on the store page. You can just hit contact, and we'll be happy to answer any of your questions. Okay, look for more of these types. We have a couple of books out there on birding. We have Birds and Squirrels, and we have a couple of Gardens of Garden of Birds volumes out there, and I'm going to keep going with those. So depending on when you're watching this, I may have 6 volumes. So keep an eye out for those. Okay, thanks very much for joining me. I'll see you next time here at the Jansenart Studio. Then have a great time painting here, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.